What's up, guys? Today I've got a really nice piece of Florida coral that I got from Pearl Yoder. If you want to find them on Facebook, you can, with a million souls mine. Completely see-through, and I'm not going to bring this light any closer to show you because I will at the end, but yeah, the lighting will get messed up. But it is pinhead coral, so there's kind of different swirls in the stone, and I actually, well, there's a little seam here that I was able to hopefully still be able to get through. But this is going to be for an individual who reached out. Don't know if they want me to reveal the name. Usually folks don't mind, but for his sake. And he wants a dovetail. So I've got a dovetail down here that I'm gonna try to mimic. And gonna use some coral. He wanted it to be, I wanna say around 4 inches. And this is a little over. So if we go above 4 inches, which I think we will, then that's what we'll do. But I've already spent about, I don't know, 20, 25 minutes getting this down to here because I'm uploading a video, but also I wanted to see what the seam would do. And I think it'll hold together. So with all that being said, let's continue. Now, for most of you, dovetails are a pretty familiar point type. To me, not so much. In the Deep South, we don't really have dovetails. We have some bowlines that look like dovetails. But just trying to push it. That platform wasn't all that great. But we don't have dovetails. So I looked up an image. I think it's of an authentic one. And then I also had the individual who wanted the point send me a video or a photo of kind of what they were thinking. And I always kind of like that so that I know I'm not just giving them something altogether random, but that I have a frame of mind of what they're thinking. So hopefully this will be nice enough for him. I gouged out a bit there, but it's okay. And in the photo I sent him, really this was just a clear, you know, before it flaked into it, it was just kind of a clear piece. But on this side, you definitely have some pinks, oranges, blues that might fade away, you know, over the coming 24 hours, but not all of it. Not in total, that's for sure. So should be some interesting colors here. Trying to get on top. Now I've used this trick before, but if you got kind of a square edge almost, you can kind of bevel out that top area and it thins the thickness down to where you can then come over it and be able to manipulate it how you need to. There we are. I just saw that Hunt Primitive put out some, I guess you'd call it artificial stone preforms. And I think I may give those a review whenever he gets back in stock. I think they sold out just that quick. But basically, I'm assuming it's kind of like a ceramic that he's able to get the same form, shape, size stone every time. Now, I don't know the price of it, but for y'all's sake, for those who are interested in saying you're beginners, I want to try that out, see if that's something that, you know, would be good. Now, if you're a beginner, what I generally ask you to do is, you could buy coral, but coral's so pretty and I don't want you to ruin it. What I would do is Texas material. That's right. Try some Texas material. And in my opinion, that's some of the best stuff to just practice on if you're a beginner. Now, I did not have that. As many of you know, I grew up on tough old coastal rock. And a part of the reason I stuck with it is because I had a buddy to help me named Lewis. But oftentimes, as Ryan Gill suggested, that if you start out with tough stone, you're, in my opinion, better off in the long haul. But if you're doing percussion, but you can tire out quick. Not physically per se, but mentally. You know, if it's just, it's easier for people to get out of the hobby by starting on tougher stones, because you don't see the progress as easy than say with something else. Like if I'm pressure flaking a raw piece of coastal, I mean, that's no fun. Look at that. Now that's a tough piece of coastal, mind you, but all that to say, I'm gonna try that out in the future. Now, in my opinion, can they make pretty points? No, I mean, not really, but that's my opinion. That's my opinion. But I think he said he's coming out with different colors other than just white. So I'll be excited to look into that. And for people who sell rock, or who sell their points, I'm curious kind of what that's going to look like. So very intriguing. I like what he's doing. And if I can support him in any way, I want to try to. I met Ryan once at one of the Florida Knap-Ins. And seems like a real genuine guy, knowledgeable guy, much more knowledgeable than I am. And yeah. Traffic on our road. And a lot of ignorant drivers, but that's everywhere. This is going to be cool if I can keep the seam in there, and I think I can. Again, I got this rock from Pearl Yoder. And he's got the best coral rock that I know of. However, it is possible that I'll be trying some more coral from a really good buddy of mine, who goes out to find some authentic coral points. And he said he's found some really good material and he'd like to get it to me to try. So I might have that upcoming in the future as well. Probably not soon, but maybe sometime. Really just inching in the flake scars. This side looks amazing. That's where one of the little seams runs, but it's not really an issue. Let's see. I'm gonna cut it again here. On here. Yep. Find a light one there. Feathering it in will be just fine. I think this will be pretty. Completely see-through dovetail. Now I'll have to figure out the base on this thing, because I've never made a base of one of these. I know I need to draw it in a bit, so bear with me. And I want to draw it in this way because there's a little bit more blue highlights there. This is more white. You get a little bit more color this way. Okay, we're still inching it in. I know I'm going a little slower than usual, but I want to make it right. That's good. Good. Very good. Very, very good. pretty good. I think we can catch any of those leftovers on the other side. Probably go this side first. Again, we can catch a lot of that from the base. Got a good chunk of it there. Good lick of it there. There we go. Kind of casually moving along here. I'm realizing I still got a ways to go here in drawing this in. So, how do I want to handle this? Let's pull this thing out first. Doing pretty solid. pull this out. All right, so that edge looks really nice. All right, now let's focus on this other side. All right, did one pass. Just kind of getting rid of those deltas. I could do this with the abrader, and I have done it that way, but this is a bit cleaner to do that first. Really clean up that edge. Usually a braid a little heavier on the second pass because I'm trying to get the form right. Okay. And one just kind of covering pass here. All right. So we haven't done any of our final stage stuff quite yet of edge work, but I do like the face of this, even with the seam that's included there. I think it looks good. I do want to go ahead and figure out what's going on back here to make sure everything's uniform. And that everything's the way that I need it to be. see this other photo here. So the boot is usually straight across. Need to braid this or shave this down pretty good. Looks like it kind of goes up a bit too. So, I have to play around with this a bit. Keep going. Flaking really nice. Now, I don't want to go too far in, so I may stop here for now. And kind of figure it out. I feel like I may go further. I may widen it a bit. For right now, we'll go with that. This one needs to be right there. What did I drop there? Maybe it was nothing crazy. Was that a good one? And so from what I'm seeing, the top shelf of this is straight across and the bottom is curved. So you're almost coming up. This is interesting. It's honestly pretty easy to notch. Especially with this material though. And also do something with my file there. I'll show you in a second. Can't remember the direction I just went in. I'll just go with this one. I usually abrade up and not in. Abrading up will allow the platform to get a tad bit lower when you need it to. I knew that'd be tricky. Do that. And a little sharpen. Yeah, I feel like that ought to have taken a little bit earlier, but we're fine. And we can hopefully still go the other way as well. Yeah. Okay, yeah, we're good. We're good. All right, now shaping up this base will be interesting. I think from this seam down here. If we can tackle it, we'll be good as golden. And I may leave it in just for kicks. I mean, why not? I'm realizing that I'm still a bit wide here. We may be able to make it work still. This will kind of be a gutting flake if it works. Which it kind of didn't. But it wasn't terrible. All right, we're getting pretty close. Just gotta kind of tidy up the edges, and I think we'll be close to done. Trying to remember if they're beveled or not. I think they are. So we're gonna bevel it. All right. I think I'm gonna go one more time here. Go ahead and sharpen my tip here. Same thing for the other side. I see you, Marshall. We're about to go in. Don't worry. All right, I think we're just about where we want to be. There we go, that's what I was after. So I don't know how perfect this is, guys. I have no idea. This might... be it, it might not be it, I don't know. But I hope that it's close enough. So here we go. Beveled slightly. Dovetail. Cool. So something different. It's got plenty of width. I think it's pretty nice. Anyways, we'll end it there. Thanks, guys, and catch you next time.